ก็สวัสดีครับทุกคน It's Aaron your head coach at Homa Today I want to talk to you a little bit about my training style and how I want to train you in the gym and how I've been training everyone the last two decades of my career in fitness So up on here it is super important that we make sure we understand what the goals are right the main goal the training age I've spoken about this before Training age is super important in the amount of experience that you've had in the training. If you've had a personal trainer or a coach or someone that has taught you some sort of like movement. Also injuries as well. That's gonna play a big part in regard to what you can do in the gym as well. Especially like with the foundation process as well. But look, generally like most people that I'm training are like these days, they want weight loss, to lower their like body fat percentage. Also a little bit of fitness as well. So that means if they can chase after like their kids or like run a 5K or something like that without being too puffed out. So the process of the training system is super important. It's all about setting a foundation. It's all about like building some endurance. And then it's about like building up muscle, right? Now I've got here like max strength and power, right? Two decades in the fitness industry, I've taken about 5% of my clients through a max strength training program and power. This is very advanced, and this is only for people that have got good posture and that can move very well as well. So if we go back, if I talk about a little bit about the foundation process, it's about correcting posture. It's about stretching, mobility, and then movement, right? If you can't move correctly, then it's gonna be pretty hard to get you to here, right? So the biggest problem I see with people in the fitness industry, personal trainers, etc., right? They take their clients straight here. So this is a muscle building up phase. We call it a hypertrophy, right? So this is a bigger weight, 8 to 10 to 12 like repetitions, okay? And it's too much of a load if you haven't got the foundation. So it's super important to set that foundation, correct the posture, have good flexibility, some mobility, and then be able to teach some good light movement. You need to be able to squat, to bend, to lunge, to push, pull, twist and gate with good technique and good posture. If you don't and you put a load on top of it, take you straight to here, it's gonna cause a massive problem, right? It might not be a month or 2 months or 3 months, but if you keep training in this type of training phase with bad posture and bad technique, it's gonna be a problem for sure. It could take 12 months or 2 years or 3 years, but it's not a good long-term strategy, all right? And I see so many people that go straight to hit, yeah, okay, it's gonna get you some fast results, but like, what would you rather? Okay, a quick result and have an injury after 3 months and not be able to train for another 3 months? So most importantly, it's gonna put your motivation right down, okay? So you're not gonna be wanting to come back because you're gonna be scared, right? And I see this a lot as well, people that come into gym that have got a shoulder injury or a back injury, they're too scared to, example, like do a deadlift or something like that. So it is super important to start here, right? With the posture correction, right? So once you've got some good posture and some good movement, right? So we can take you through some more endurance training. So what this means is starting to load on that squat and the bend and the lunge, the push, pull, twist and gate. But it's not a big load, right? It's more about just still teaching some movements and obviously keeping that rep range up super high to build that endurance. That means around the 15 to 20 repetitions. Okay, functional integration is something super important. And this is, I see a lot of bodybuilders that haven't got that functional integration because they've done a lot of training on machines, right? Even though you've got good posture and you've got good movement, so now we need to integrate and get that core to work. When we go into the bigger compound lifting, your deadlifts and squats and stuff like that as well, right? So obviously, again, we need to keep that load down light, right? And not too heavy. Otherwise, if we go too heavy, right, the core muscles and the postural stabilizers are not going to activate as well, and we start to use them bigger muscle groups again, which can cause pain. Example, in the back pain, shoulder pain, or neck pain. So endurance is all about a lightweight, okay, and then starting to build up like the repetitions, 2 to 3 sets, right? So when we go into like muscle like building, it's more about starting to load now. So this is a fun phase where people start to get like good results. And for me, I always go by feel by each individual client, right? So some people, if they're doing all their homework in the foundation process, so this is stuff that you're gonna be doing at home, okay, it's more on a daily basis, like foam rolling, stretching, core conditioning, rotator cuff work, all that sort of stuff is gonna help to get you here a lot quicker, right? So obviously, and then we can start to load up on the weights and obviously start to get a good result as well, right? Taking into the hypertrophy phase is going to build the muscle, right? And this is where all us personal trainers wanna get you there, but you gotta go through that process first, right? Inexperienced trainers are gonna take you straight there and it's gonna be short-term lived, trust me. So like once we've got some good strength, so we can go into start to load up a little bit more. It's gonna be great for metabolism, starting to burn more fat and get you a more change of shape in your body, most people want in the weight loss to lower their body fat. So these two phases here, like I said, max strength, it's not really a priority for these type of goals. Power is a great fat loss training phase, but most people haven't got the foundation to progress to, even though we go into like muscle like building. So this is still very advanced lifting. So if we talk about things like CrossFit, okay, so this is a lot of power training, and this is like where a lot of people get injured as well. Okay, so CrossFit is another can of worms, but I won't go too much into it, but it's for like more advanced people that have been training, that have got a higher training age, right? So a lot of people start in CrossFit and stuff like that, and they get injured because they've skipped all these other phases, right? So it's super important to make sure we set that foundation. What I do with all my clients before they come in and we start training, I take them through a consultation. That consultation consists of the postural assessments, right? Having a look at the pelvic position, spinal curvatures. So we do some core testing, some shoulder testing, some glute testing, and then I just assess all the movements as well and start to teach some of those primal like movement patterns to get you like ready to start your training into endurance and take you through safely so you can have some great tools to be training. It's not just like for the next 10 sessions or 12 weeks, but for the rest of your life, you can be injury free. If you're interested in coming down for a postural assessment, just click the link below and I would love to have a chat, make a booking like with you. Ciao for now.